हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर शुभ अरोड़ा फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स जिम्स ग्रेटर नोएडा। वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू बैक फॉर द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट। करंटली वी आर ऑन द सेकेंड यूनिट एंड टुडे इज़ द फोर्थ लेक्चर एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ प्राइसिंग मेथड्स। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी कवर्ड अबाउट द प्रोडक्ट लाइफ साइकिल एंड प्राइसिंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट प्राइसिंग मेथड्स। सो लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय प्राइसिंग मेथड्स। व्हेन वी से प्राइसिंग मेथड, इट मीन्स और इन्वॉल्व्स सम काइंड ऑफ वेज एंड मैनर्स इन विच द price of goods and services can be calculated, right? And while calculating the price of goods and services, certain factors are to be considered, like the competition, the target audience, the current stage of product life cycle of that particular product, then the vision of expansion of the firm. So these are certain factors which are to be kept in mind and considered while fixing a price for a particular product or service. So these are the different methods. So basically the way of pricing can be done in two ways, cost oriented pricing and market oriented pricing, right? And further they are subcategorized. So when we talk about cost oriented pricing, it includes cost plus pricing, markup pricing, target return pricing. And when we talk about and classify market oriented pricing, it includes perceived value pricing, value pricing, going rate pricing, auction type pricing and differential pricing. So let's discuss all of these in detail one by one. First let's talk about the cost oriented pricing method. What does this mean? This, as the name suggests and the term says itself, defines that it is related to, or the entire orientation or approach is related to cost, right? So here the main factor which is considered by the firm while fixing the price is the cost of production. So the base is for calculating the price is the cost of production, right? So finished goods price is decided based on the cost of production which is being incurred by the organization. Now again, cost oriented pricing method is further subcategorized as we just saw in the figure in the previous slide. So the first is cost plus pricing. Now what does this cost plus pricing says? It is a very simple method because here the manufacturer tries to calculate the cost of production incurred, and after calculating the cost of production incurred on a particular unit, it adds a certain percentage of markup to that cost of production. For example, if cost of production for one unit of a product is rupees 500, right? So 500 plus the organization wants to keep a markup on the total cost which has been incurred in producing that product, that markup would be 25% as per the organization. So how it will be calculated now? It can be calculated that selling price will be decided on cost of production plus cost of production divided into markup percentage, that is 25 divided by 100. So what do we get? We get 125 rupees. So 500 was the cost of production and markup is 125. So the selling price which will be decided by the organization would be 625. Right? So this is how cost plus pricing is done. Now in cost oriented, let's see the second category, that is the markup pricing. When we talk about markup pricing, it includes adding a constant percentage to the cost price of an item, right? To arrive at the selling price, right? So this method is basically the variation. This method basically kind of variation the cost plus method which we just discussed previously, right? So here what happens is the pricing policy is often used by the reseller. So who uses this kind of markup kind of prices? It is mainly used by the resellers. And who are the resellers? Resellers are like the wholesalers, the distributors, the retailers, right? So they basically keep a percentage of profit which is added on the price on which they bought the product from the manufacturer, and after adding the markup percentage, they sell, then they decide the selling price and sell it in the market to the consumers, right? Next, here you can also see in formula that how markup pricing is done. Product cost divided by 100 minus markup percentage, which is decided by the reseller in the market, divided by 100, right? Now we come to the second approach, that is the market. Now that was cost oriented. Now here we are talking about market oriented pricing method. So in this, the entire price fixing the price or deciding the price, the entire focus of the marketer here is looking into or considering the market conditions, right? So the first method is perceived value pricing. When we talk about perceived value pricing, here the manufacturer decides the price on the basis of the consumer's perception regarding the goods and services, right? Taking into consideration various elements like advertising, promotional tools, additional benefits of the product, product quality, channels of distributions which are involved in promoting or supplying that product into the market, right? So all these elements put a direct impact on the customer's mind in framing the perception regarding the firm in the mind of the customer, right? So basically when this type of perceived value pricing is done, the main focus is that what kind of perception customer has in its mind regarding the brand, right? For example, if we talk about a customer buys Sony products, right? So despite less priced products available in the market, this is because Sony company follows the perceived pricing policy. If same kind of product is available at lesser price, but I as a customer prefer products related to buying product of Sony brand only. Why? Because I as a customer have a perceived perception that if I am paying something extra or a higher price for the same kind of product which is available as at a lesser price in the market, but the brand is Sony. So this is perceived value which I as a customer have in my mind regarding that brand. Now we come to the B point of market oriented pricing method. Here we'll talk about value pricing. In this kind of pricing method, companies design the low priced products and try to maintain the quality which they are offering, right? So basically quality is not getting affected, but only what the organization, the strategy which the organization is trying to follow is that the price is being decreased, right? Kept low, and the quality is maintained as it is, right? How? Because here the organization is trying to maintain the quality at a lower price by trying to use such kind of technology or some trying to redesign or trying to bring up a product in the market which is re-engineered in such a way where the cost of production which the organization is incurring is lesser. So since the cost of production is lesser, the price can be reduced and the same kind of quality product can be supplied in the market, right? Its best example for this is Tata Nano. Brand is Tata, right? Value pricing, the price which was fixed for Tata Nano car was very affordable and was a value price, right? Despite Tata cars, the company tried to design a car with all the necessary features at a very low price and lived up to its quality. Now we'll talk about the C part, that is going rate pricing. What is this kind of pricing method says? The firm considers the competitor's price as a base. Here the base price or the base is considered as the competitor's price for that product in the market, right? Whatever price competitor is charging for the same kind of product in the market, looking into the competitor's price, the organization will fix the price of its product. Either it will be a little lesser from the competitor's price or slight higher, right? Examples of such kind of pricing, going rate pricing are in steel industry, paper, fertilizers, etc. Right? Now we'll talk about the fourth one, that is the auction pricing method, which says that it includes certain three types of auctions. First is English auction. When we talk about English auction, there what is the condition? The seller is single and buyers are many. The seller tries to put the item on websites like Yahoo and bidders raise the price until the top best price is reached. Second type of auction type of pricing is Dutch auctions. Here one seller and many buyers, or one buyer and many sellers. That means vice versa condition can be there. In the first case, when the seller is single and buyers are various or many buyers are there, the top best price is announced and then slowly it comes down. That suits the bidder. Whereas in the second case, where the buyer is single and sellers are various, there are a number of sellers, what happens? The buyer announces the product, what he wants to buy at, and then the potential sellers compete by offering the lowest price to the buyer. Now we come to the third type of auction type of pricing, that is the sealed bid auction. This kind of method is very common in the case of government or industrial purchases, where what happens, the tenders are floated right in the market, and whosoever wants to take that tender, that supplier can bid the price in a closed envelope, right? And that bid price will not be disclosed to anyone except the authorities concerned to it. Now we come to the next type of market oriented pricing method, that is a differential pricing. Now this is adopted when different prices have to be charged from the different groups of customers, right? So different groups of customers, different types of prices, right? And how these prices vary based on certain factors like time, area and product form. Example, mineral water or soft drinks, same packaging, same quantity, are you as a customer at different locations, you pay differently, right? For example, if you are sitting in a 5-star hotel, you'll pay this a different price for that 1 liter mineral water bottle if you are sitting in a 5-star hotel, and you'll pay a different price if you are sitting on a highway hotel, right? Or a restaurant located at a highway, then you'll say you'll pay a different price for the same mineral water bottle, same quantity, if you are purchasing it from a railway station or from a retail store, right? So different prices for the same product, but these variations in the prices are due to certain factors like with respect to time, product form and the area. So that's all for today's class. We are done with the pricing objectives and pricing methods. In the following lecture, we'll be discussing about the pricing strategies. Thank you. Take care.